And now, back to road tripping on the Capizzo Show. Back on the road, today we'll be traveling to Detroit, Michigan, Motor City capital of the world and home to the Ford Motor Company where they make the mighty Ford trucks. Henry Ford was born in 1863 from humble beginnings in Dearborn, Michigan. In 1903, he opened the Ford Motor Company, proclaiming, "I will build the car for the great multitudes." I'm a truck guy. I buy trucks. I love trucks. I love the way they drive. And I'm excited to go see where they're built at the Rouge Ford factory just outside of Detroit. Now this place is like a tiny city.
People came from all over the world to see the Rouge because it was the biggest of its kind. 1¾ miles long, 3/4 mile wide, an industrial plant that made cars from raw materials to the finished product.
We are here at the Ford Rouge plant, and behind me is the largest single living roof in the world, the Guinness certified. It keeps the temperature 10 degrees cooler in the summer and 10 degrees warmer in the winter.
But all the initiatives that they're doing around here environmentally are meant to clear up this whole area. They have a program where in the years to come, anything that's not, where there's not a building at the Rouge is gonna be green. And that's the whole idea, and that is going around the whole world at this time.
In 1908, he invented the Model T, which sold for $950. And after almost 20 years of production, they sold over 15 million cars.
It's the whole history of the vehicles that Ford made, from the Model T to the Model A to the cars and trucks that we're making today. That's the main thing. This place is an icon.
Keeping with Henry Ford's vision, the Rouge factory incorporates a strong community feeling with a productive working environment.
We have the stages that you go through here at the Rouge to see this done. You go through the past, the present, and the future of the Ford Motor Company, and it's really something to see.
What's the most amazing vehicle Ford makes?
F-150, there's no doubt in my mind. Top selling vehicle for the last 25 years, top selling truck for the last 30 years. So there's gotta be something in the quality and the make of this vehicle. It is a top selling vehicle.
I love my truck. It's really amazing how they put those F-150s together when you watch it in the production line. They go by and each person has his own job that he does on every car, and it just systematically goes together like magic. And to be able to watch that is really a great privilege. Henry Ford, who founded the Ford Motor Company, was also a bit of a collector. Actually, he was the collector. The collection speaks for a man that saw the future with historical relics that remind us of the luxuries we are afforded today. Modern ideas that are still ahead of their time are seen everywhere. Ford was a good friend to many modern innovators, such as Thomas Edison, Charles Lindbergh, and the Wright brothers. It's amazing to see the history books that you studied in school come to life as you walk through this enormous collection. Henry Ford also paved the way for mass production, which ultimately brought us roads and suburbs. He also has the car Kennedy was shot in, the car Reagan was shot in, and the chair Lincoln was shot in. And also the bus that Rosa Parks refused to give up her seat on. I was totally blown away by this collection. I recommend that anyone, while they're in the Detroit area, go and check it out. From our vantage point in Detroit, we were able to see Canada.